Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's Roethlisberger Steelers going up against Wilson's Seahawks. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Seattle Seahawks. Send Brown in motion right. Here's the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. This offense has some speed, and certainly Martavis Bryant, he has some speed.
He has that, and he has size. That's what makes him so difficult to cover. Because just when you think you have to play him one way, the other attribute kicks in. Martavis Bryant could be an all-star real soon.
In motion is Coates. Again, it's Bell. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5. The Seahawks, here's their defensive lineup.
Michael Bennett is one of the best pass-rushing defensive linemen in the game. Normally plays defensive end, but when they go to those nickel packages and he works inside, look out, offensive guards, you've got a problem.
To throw here, Roethlisberger. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped, altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it, and now 4th down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Green, the tight end, in motion. They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. A big connection on that one. 31 yards.
And they pick up the first down on a 4th down play. I don't know if the defense relaxed because they thought maybe they'd stopped him on 3rd down, or if they just didn't protect the sticks very well. But boy, that's a big time pickup right there.
In motion is Coates. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
Anytime a team goes on the road, there's always that little bit of fear that maybe they can be affected by the hometown crowd. But this is where game planning really came into play. They talked about it all week. Go in there, establish yourselves. Well, that run right there, that slows down the crowd and gives them a lot of confidence.
In 12 regular season games this last year for Bell, averaging over 150 yards from scrimmage. First two games in the playoffs were great, but you know, getting injured in the final game probably leaves a bad taste in his mouth.
Leaves a bad taste, gives him fuel for the next season, though, because remember, for the last few years, he hasn't been able to play a full season for various reasons. Now, going into next year, imagine those numbers over a 16-game season. And heading into the playoffs, Le'Veon Bell can set new records.
Hurry up, let's go! Hurry up, let's go! Hurry up, let's go!
On second down, it's Bell. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It's a loss of two. Now third down. Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. In motion is Coates. Now Roethlisberger to throw. He's got his tight end. That's James. Touchdown, Steelers. Jesse James from 10 yards out. And the Steelers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. The play clock's running down. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Steps away. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. And this offense often hinges on one of the best tight ends in the league, and that's Jimmy Graham.
I think he made up for lost time when he got to the NFL because in college, he was mainly a basketball player, a defender who couldn't score. Now he's flipped it around in the NFL. Every time he touches the ball, he's a threat to score.
And the starting defensive unit here for Pittsburgh.
Cameron Hayward is a defensive lineman. But many of us, especially guys of my vintage, remember his father, Craig Ironhead Hayward, who was a running back. I think Cameron decided he'd rather hit people than be hit.
On third down, Wilson. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. In motion is Coates. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Now a first down carry by Bell. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave them with a third and 11.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On third down, Roethlisberger. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. So on fourth down, the Steelers call on the number of Chris Boswell for the field goal try. From the left hash mark, this a 43-yard attempt. And Boswell's kick is good. And that will make our score 9-0. The offense got the ball in a good spot, but they went nowhere. They settled for three.
Brandon, I think it's safe to say that was a major disappointment. Had a great opportunity, excellent field position, and did not be able to move the ball at all. Big time letdown.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. A good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
On first down, pro size. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. CJ Pro Size, 36 yards. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. And it's up and good. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Brown, the lone receiver left. Here's Roethlisberger. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Now Roethlisberger, and this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. They'll run it now out of the gun. And room there to work it inside the 25. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
And he stopped immediately there. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
Interesting. A chip shot field goal here would give them the lead, but instead, they're going on fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to...
And he's across the chalk, into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. A great play there. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This is fielded at the goal line. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
They come out here in the eye. In motion is Coates. They'll go again with Bell. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. Green, the tight end, in motion. To throw here, Roethlisberger. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
You know, when I see passes like that, I'm reminded of something you and I talked about yesterday. Big Ben was a wide receiver the first 3 years of high school, sitting behind the coach's son. And then he finally got that opportunity. I think he's made the most of it.
It's always the coach's son, isn't it? But you know where it helps him? When he looks downfield, he knows what the receivers are going to do. He actually has wide receivers' eyes when he's throwing the ball.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to CenturyLink Field after this. In motion is Coates. Back to the ground, this time with Bell. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And some space here. It's a gain of 17, and it'll give him a first down.
That's funny, partner. Le'Veon Bell, when he came out of Michigan State, when I go back and look at my analysis of him and what my grades were for him, I thought he was a big-time player, great potential, but I didn't know we were going to get this player. I was used to a big, solid, thick running back, but now I've got a full package, a guy that can do everything, as we just saw there, including breaking tackles.
But at the time, second-round pick in 2013, some people probably wishing they'd taken him in the first. They come out here in the eye. In motion is Coates. Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, a 22-yard scamper. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead. And he's able to put it through. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain? Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now Wilson on first down. And this one is incomplete. Second down following the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And now they're in the hurry up.
You don't have to be a finished product to show some pretty good glimpses of what could be in this league. And we just saw an example of it on that nice run there. When I looked at him coming out of college, I saw a guy with raw, terrific ability. I couldn't wait to see how it was going to be harnessed and polished up in the NFL. In fact, some people thought he could play a little slot receiver as well as run the football. This guy has the ability to be a big-time player with more seasoning.
And the back goes into motion. And the wideout in motion. Second and 10. It's Wilson again. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawks touchdown. Jermaine Kearse, 26 yards. And the Seahawks have once again taken the lead. And this one through the uprights and good. Get out to send this one away following the score. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Now it's Roethlisberger looking deep downfield. He's got a man complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
I think one of the underrated aspects of Ben Roethlisberger's game is his ability to actually throw the football. We hear so much about his movement and escaping the pocket. Ben can step back there and fling it, and Antonio Brown is usually there to catch.
We've really seen their chemistry develop, haven't we?
Yes, we have, and it's been really, really fun to watch.
Now Roethlisberger to throw. It's complete to Brown, right side. Brown finishing 2016 with over 1,200 yards, 106 receptions. Now for him, you know, people were expecting maybe some bigger numbers. Charles, what did you make of Antonio Brown's season?
Well, what I made of it is that he started to get more help along the way. Jesse James developed at tight end. Once Le'Veon Bell got into the lineup, he started to catch passes out of the backfield and ate up a few numbers as well. So Big Ben had more targets to throw it to. That should help Antonio Brown going forward in 2017. Because he'll still be the primary guy. But when you get help, boy, you can make bigger plays downfield.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. This will be a 37-yard attempt. And Boswell's kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage 3 here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
So 2 quarters down, 2. And hello, I guess Larry's halftime show was buttoned through. And we are moving on and ready to go for the third quarter. Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Looking for Baldwin, intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And they have possession.
possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. In motion is Coates. The second half starts with a carry by Bell, and he'll take this one down to the 36. A gain of 3, second down.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
They'll send a receiver in motion left. Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Green, the tight end, in motion. On third down, Roethlisberger. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Now a first down carry, it's Williams. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about 4. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
In motion is Coates. Again, it's Williams. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6. Great play there off the end. Question, Charles, in a 4-3, you hear about the D tackles a lot. What's the role of the ends?
What they want to do is control the edges of the defense. And you always hear about an offense talking about setting the edge in the running game. Well, the defense wants to do exactly the same thing. And the defensive end, often against an offensive tackle, sometimes a tight end, they can't let themselves get a hook and let a running back get outside. Because if they do that, that hurts the integrity of the defense overall.
My man, the encyclopedia. It goes for a gain of 10, and it's a first down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
In motion is Coates. The give is to Bell. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up the play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
And incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
8th play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on 3rd down. Green, the tight end, in motion. Now Roethlisberger surveying the field. Flush to his right. And he's in for 6 and a Steeler touchdown. Ben Roethlisberger, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Steelers have once again taken the lead. Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? But I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat them on that play all the way to the end zone.
The Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. 75 yards. And the Seahawks have once again taken the lead. It took them a while to get their speedster involved, but they found it downfield there.
And what we've discovered as we've watched games is the speedster doesn't have to have a lot of catches, doesn't have to have volume in order to have a huge impact on the game. His speed scares the heck out of defenses, and other guys can capitalize, but when you finally hit him and he carries it all the way into the end zone, that's what you're paying him for. That big threat that can make big plays on a limited number of catches.
That's how you step on the stage with your first catch. Take it to the house. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent. But you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Brown, the lone receiver left. On second down, Roethlisberger. Man open left side is Brown. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. A give to Bell. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Partner, that defensive win reminds me of something a coach of mine used to say all the time. If you really want it, you'll find a way to go get it. And the defense did exactly that.
Back now in Seattle, Washington. And we've got a dandy here. A one-point game as we begin the fourth. Green, the tight end, in motion. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46.
And while it didn't work very well on that play, defenders on third and short know it's going to be a quick read. And really, the quarterback's just going to turn around and hand it off. So that way, you're able to diagnose the play and try and get to the point of attack. But when you're dealing with a fullback, it's hard to knock him backwards.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. In motion is Coates. They'll run it with Bell. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position, the guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front is eating up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
Slot man moves right. On on second down, Williams. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
That's a nice play by the defense, but the offense can't let that one play define them. Let it go, move on, and start over again.
Here comes the seventh play now of this drive, as this is third and ten. And he motions the wide receiver. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. And that is incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And now it's fourth down.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on fourth down. Being chased out left. He gets it to Brown. Complete. That'll be a pickup of 29 yards there. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
In motion is Coates. They come out here in the eye. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. They'll go back to the ground with Bell. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. They'll try the right side with Bell. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Le'Veon Bell with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Steelers have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So a big play now as the Steelers will go for two. Roethlisberger looking to throw. And it is incomplete, so they can't convert for two. And now the lead stays at five. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's true.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. It'll go as a gain of 12. And it's good enough for a Seattle first. So here we go, first and 10 now. Back to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
He's back to throw. They'll roll him out right.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line...
Now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Green, the tight end, in motion. Roethlisberger going to throw it. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
And the wideout in motion. Here's Roethlisberger. Green with a catch left side. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. And now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And here's a big one now, trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Brown, the lone receiver left. The Steelers will go. It's Roethlisberger. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowl quarterback, Richard Sherman. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other fire. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take this one down to the 20-yard line.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Back to throw. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and ten. They'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
Well, partner, so much for the mismatch. How about the guy at the second level, that big linebacker, able to run with the receiver and make a play on the football?
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. He'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse, and that brings up fourth down. And down by five, they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Only one timeout defensively, so this should just be a simple kneel down.
I agree totally. I looked at my time management chart. It says take a knee, victory formation. They just have one timeout left. And that should be all she wrote.
By the way, it's a good thing you can read that because nobody else can.
Not with my chicken scratch, not at all.
Well, certainly a tough loss here, but they've got to move on. I mean, you have another opponent next week. You dwell on this one, it hurts you the following week.
That's where the 24-hour rule comes into play, win or lose for all teams. Either enjoy the win for 24 or reflect on the loss for 24, then put it aside and move forward.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. From Seattle, so long, everybody.
Hard to admit that I used to draw. Portraiture in a human form. Doodle of a two-headed unicorn. It was soothing. Moving his arm in a fusion of man-made tools and amused from beyond, even if it went beautifully wrong. It was tangible truth for a youth to refuse to belong. No name nuisance. Stews in a bedroom. Ooze in a brand new cuneiform. Barely commune with the horde. Got a whole grayscale ungluing his world. Might zone amp to the yap of the magpie. Unseen hand dragging his graphite. Cross contour, little bit of backlight. Black ink after a Bristol to baptize. You can imagine a rush that ensue when you get three dimensions stuffed in a two. Then it's off to a school where it's all you get to. Being trained and observed by a capable few. Back in New York by peeps and a dog in a two-bedroom. Rhyming and stealing and being a clod. Distractions, freedom, a rod. I left some years of giving a light. I left some will the spirit away. I let my fears materialize. I let my skills deteriorate. Horned by the thought of what I should have been. Continuing a mission that was rooted in a 20-year affinity and rickety condition with an ID crisis. Snap on the front lawn, look up in the sky. It's
shapes falling out of the fringe. All heart though we would have made cowardly kings. They will chop you down just to count your rings. Just to count your rings. Just to count your rings. And now we're colors pouring out of the fringe. All heart though we would have made cowardly kings. They will chop you down just to count your rings. Just to count your rings. Just to count your rings.
Used to paint. Hard to admit that I used to paint. Natural light on a human face. Stenciled fire in his roommate's face. It was blooming addiction. A miss and a push and a pigment. Book like a tattooed pigskin look. Pinhead kids at a minute. Drank Kool-Aid from a tube of acrylic. And I grew up in a linseed oil or a linen. Joy to the poison. Voice to the resin. Capture a map at a gesture. Back up at a...
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Wilson Seahawks going up against Roethlisberger Steelers. And with that, we'll send you up to the North Shore of Pittsburgh at Heinz Field by the Three Rivers as we head it over to our broadcasting team of Brandon Gaughan and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Seattle Seahawks and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Motion is Coates. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33. Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Now Bell. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Now a carry for the veteran. This is D'Angelo Williams. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's 2nd and 2. In motion is Coates. They run it again with Williams. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Ataba Rubin makes the stop. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. On 3rd down, here's Bell. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. He completes it to Bryant, and he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
Throwing now, Roethlisberger on 1st down. Out left side here to Bryant. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Man in motion right, Antonio Brown. Bell. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. 7 yards to go on 2nd down. This is Bell. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to 3rd down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Play number 9 now on this pretty long opening drive. But this is 3rd down. Green, the tight end, in motion. From the gun on 3rd down, it's Roethlisberger. And it's caught. It's Brown. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown from 8 yards out. And the Steelers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And he knocks it through. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown.
action here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. Oh, he's going to take it. And got his man complete. And he takes it down deep into Pittsburgh territory. It's a big hook up there. Wilson to Baldwin. 55 yards. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Now a play fake here on first down. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Escaping the pressure right. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It'll be a gain of 9, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on 3rd and 1.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
He'll buy some time right. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Tyler Lockett from 10 yards out. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. So he scrambled right, but was able to look back toward the middle of the end zone to find the target.
As you know, in this game, sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, because we all know most guys throwing the football are taught never throw back into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Instinct and vision. Sometimes you just see people who are open, you're able to get it to them.
And now out come the Steelers. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do.
Now Bell hit. He lost the football.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. The slot man in motion right. Now Roethlisberger to throw on 2nd down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. That one good for 10 yards. And they're going to have a 3rd down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end. But running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
In motion left is Rodgers. Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number 2. They'll face a 3rd down conversion attempt here, 3rd and 3. Motions the wide receiver. Roethlisberger now to throw on 3rd down. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he will have 1st down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height,
Le'Veon Bell. Kiss him goodbye. And he cuts it out left sideline. Room ahead. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell, 59 yards. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction, because as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Now it's Wilson. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
Done a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
No, I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. Hopping over the top. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. A lost opportunity.
Pete Carroll rolled the dice, but it didn't work out. And this Steeler defense able to come up with a stop. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Here's Bell. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. They come out here in the eye. In motion is Coates. Now it's Roethlisberger. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Roethlisberger. Incomplete.
And the Seahawks add a couple of extra DBs going with the dime look here.
Indeed, six on the field. On third down, Roethlisberger. And down he goes.
Jones. A sack. They sack him back across midfield at about the 48-yard line. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
Well, what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case,
a fight for the football, and it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowl cornerback, Richard Sherman, and they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And this offense, last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still...
And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle! Jermaine Kearse, 54 yards. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. Good pass, clean catch, and a house call there on the fly route.
And not that much room to operate. So that tells you about his acceleration. We always talk about being able to go from 0 to 60 real fast. It took him less time than that to get to top speed and complete that play.
The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Green, the tight end, in motion. On third and one, it's Roethlisberger. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got a bump down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up.
And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Green, the tight end, in motion. Again, it's Roethlisberger. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Play action. It's Wilson.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they're trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop the jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. On third down, Wilson forced out to his left. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. Are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And likely just out of field goal range, could be Hail Mary time.
And haven't we seen in recent years that the Hail Mary seems to be more successful in the NFL than before?
Absolutely we have. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Play of the half. It's Roethlisberger. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three.
Seattle now ready to march out of the field. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this hope? And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. All right, different topic here. 2018, the Super Bowl, traveling north, far north to Minneapolis. Early predictions for that one. Who you got?
Well, you know, everyone's still waiting in the NFL for a home team to play in its home stadium, right? So could the Vikings be that team? I'll start in the NFC, and I'm going to say no. I think Seattle, starting to get near that maybe last run with their defense. Burrow Thomas returns. I like Seattle coming out of the NFC. How about you?
Well, I'm actually going to take a Dallas Cowboys NFC title run. I think that they came so close this year, probably most talented going into next year.
I like that one. Well, in the AFC, I'm going to go with a team that if they improve their defense and their quarterback stays healthy, they could be that team, the Oakland Raiders.
Okay, I'm going dark horse. Cleveland Browns.
Let's go. Hey, from worst to first.
Wilson toward the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
Now Wilson. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Oh, they go with a tight end carry. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. The pigskin on the 7-yard line now. It's first and goal. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
When that works, your offensive coordinator looks like a genius. When it doesn't, at least folks say, what are you doing? Down here, I'd rather have my tailback running off tackle.
And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Doug Baldwin, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Seahawks are going to take the lead. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number 2. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. In motion is Coates. He'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32. And credit the tackle to Cliff Avril.
But really, that was no surprise there. They've been running it well all game. And I know goals change all the time, but any team will take that type of run each and every time.
Green, the tight end, in motion. Roethlisberger now to throw on 3rd down. He completes it to Bryant. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Now, that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
In motion is Coates. Roethlisberger with a give. It's Williams. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. Tackle made by Deshaun Shedd. So 2nd and 9, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here.
They come out here in the eye. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Now Ben, going to give it to Williams. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. He gets it to Brown, complete. A gain of 13 and also a first down.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think? A guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. He's fumbled already once, Charles. I'm not going to say that that was in his mind there, but I'm sure that during some of these plays, he is mindful of it.
And once you fumble the ball, you know what your team tells you and your coaching staff? Take care of it. Rest of the game. And that does get in your mind a little bit, and sometimes that slows down your effort in trying to get free from tacklers.
And the defenders know it, too. They sniff that out, don't they?
Everybody wants to swarm the football. You know the rule is, first guy hold up the runner, everyone else try and get there and strip the ball free.
And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And not much on the return there. He'll take it only up to the 9-yard line. And out now come the Seahawks. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
Back now in Pittsburgh. It's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now Wilson on second down. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Defense looking to hold serve one last time here on third and seven. From the gun on third down, Wilson going for the deep ball. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four's caught. Oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Again, it's Bell. And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
Green, the tight end, in motion. On third down, Roethlisberger. That's complete, right around the eight.
They do get 9, but it leads to 4th down.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Now they'll put a receiver in motion left. They'll go for it with Bell. Oh, no, he lost the football. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the Seahawks are going to take over the football. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. To Procise. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. Give them 12 yards on that one. It earns them a fresh set of downs.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end, you can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. They come up in an offset eye. They'll run it here. This is Reese. Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. 10 yards to go on third. Now Wilson. He's got time. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Finding time. Escapes the sack. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. And last time, they had it 4th and goal. Rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. Ten yards still left on 2nd down. So the D-line's going to spread out. They come out here in the eye. In motion is Coates. On 2nd down, it's Bell. And they'll get him down right around the 16. Just a couple there on the 2nd down run. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8 situation. And this defense looks for one more stop here. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll look to throw. Green with a catch left side. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the 1st down as he's tackled at the 1.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence.
And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
First and goal. They'll look to smash it in. And yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he is not going to reach the goal line. A courageous call to try for two, but they will remain down by a point. And this is going to be taken in by the Seahawks. And it would appear they're...
We set the roof, we set the roof, we set the roof on fire.
Slow. So bad, bad woman in my bed. Off with that, off with that. Young Slim, get it in my infrared. Come and hit the brain, I just lit the gas. Young, wild, winning, living fast. Stashing money in a brown paper bag. We set the roof on fire, then we flood it out. We just threw the money up, we ain't even count. Shake it, shake it in my speeder, girl, I'm nothing. Messing up my speech. I'm $1 million player, baby. Nothing's at my reach. I'm $1 million, like I hit the lottery. Splash her with cash, had the spares on the waitress. She messed up my order 3 times in a row. I'm good on gas, I just filled up my tank. Now let's fill up her head and let's see if she goes.
We set the roof on fire. 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 We set the roof on fire.
Show me what you like. Hey, I put money, I can match it for ya. I'm in this in all white fit, looking like a brick and all them zippers on a jacket on ya. He got a thing for a Latin. He wanna hear a little Spanish in it. Ha, I told him it ain't practice it. I'm about to fill it up with Spanish rings. Rock up with the click and I ain't looking like the side in this. I'm the opposite, cause I'm the main event and boxing in it. As the time been ticking, I've been out here playing my position. I'm about to get it, now ain't no one about to block my hit. Cause
someday, I'm somewhere, doing all right, somewhere, somewhere, somebody got someone, someone, somebody that.
here for a minute. Bet you want a girl to keep it independent. And I know you gotta like a girl that's disappealing. Get you caught up in the moment, then I'll get you in your feelings. Tell your boys that you gon' meet them later on. Both of us are so taxi, leave the meter on. First time you out in Cali, never tried no this strong. So you gon' have some stories to tell when you take it back home. And tell them one time, Snowy always showed you what it's like. Leave you sleepy like the call the umpire. Get you out and get you rolling, get you. Gotta go, I got a flight up in the morning on
Sunday. That can get it independent and he looking for no love, yo. He trying to catch me in my feelings, but he don't know that I'm the big dog. He trying to stunt and give me drinks. I got the bottle in the section and I pop it.
Love the clip. I thought they love you when you make it. This some mud. Yeah, yeah, yeah. that is some mother. Friends and business don't mix, so I'm brotherless. Tryna get back close, hit them with the stiff. Gears I shift, make sure they feel the drift. Just cop the Benz, oh, with the tint. You should know, cause in every song I said, yeah. In every song I said, I'm just proud of my accomplishments. I'm a 400, I don't care at all. Have a, the head, no, heard you. Tell them about, I'm real, I'm fraud. Your kids and bro, they straight, you shouldn't care at all.
Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave.
Yeah. 104 times how it go down. Slaps on deck for the whole town. On mama's, man, I did it with my own sound. And I got my own city that I hold down. Just admit it already. You got plans to do it, boy, we did it already. Got a couple DMs, I done slid in already. Gotta ask YG if he hit it already. Yeah, I'm a star like Moesha's. Running up the numbers like Aisha's. Yeah, I be sliding, I be creeping. Girls these days, they just don't know how to keep it. But I got it all handled. They try to box me and I got my own angles, yeah. I'ma spend the summer getting to the cake and I'ma wishing wood on every candle. I'm like,
please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave.
You ain't know me, but you know now. Juicy can't throw with the verse for me both times. In Pot Town, that's automatic, hold down.
What's that?
Ask no questions, just hold it down. Why you hating on the progress? I'm a humble, I don't even project.
What I do?
I just drive the Maybach through the projects. And still brazy, I ain't even drive shit.
Hate from a distance, please don't try me. Cause we'll turn it up on anybody. I see why they don't like me. Yelling out 400, they go too heavy. I'm with the posse back at it.
Whoa.
That mean, come on, I go on platinum.
Whoa.
That mean, I got a kingdom with my mattress. Oh, I got the bitty back breaking.
Please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please, please tell me why you always leave.
Why you what?
Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always
leave. Na 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 na
na na.
Thank you. gon' blow your whole mind. When I was back home washing them dishes, I was just wishing I could just vision. I was gon' get it, I was on missions, I was just living. Walked in that building, we was just building, taking our time. We was just yielding, we was just yielding. Away from these haters, know they be watching like a theater. Yeah. Plotting these niggas that we need later. They gon' degrade us, it won't delay us. This is what made us, we got Omega. Probably roll, probably just leave. I see you later, I salute Wega. Cop a new crib, got some new neighbors. You get this big, they gon' want favors, they gon' want flavors. Probably roll. Hope the Lord save us, wait from these haters. Hope the Lord save us, wait from these snakes, wait from these fakes. Wait, I need breaks, wait, I need cake. How long can we wait? Come
you
on,
better not be the one to doubt us.
Cause we've been putting in the mower. We only taking what was ours. So you better not be the one to doubt us. Cause we gon' blow your mind.
Boyfriend's got a cauliflower, and I'm a so sue me. Who are you, Judge Judy? Stacking the rubies. If life was a movie, then you could just call me the Goonies. You're not relevant. Trolling on the internet. No respect. Haven't moved out of your parents' basement yet. Big neck. Coming with the beat that's gonna break your neck.
Yeah, you can hear me now.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? If you like it loud,
then
you can make it loud. Yeah, you can hear me now.
To your city, sending bass into your earlobes like your bleached out hair, dudes.
We glowing in the dark, got the spark, about to flare the fuse. That's just how we do.
Geronimo parachute, skydiving off your parents' roof. Crew saw the magician's assistant in half, like who the f- are you?
Who the f- are you?
Who the f- are we? We be the dudes who just come over to water the lawn. We don't say hi, we just come over to walk your dog. We nice like that, we super nice like that.
You can hear me now.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? If you like it loud, we can make it loud. Can you hold it down? Cause we can hold it down. Yeah, you can hear me now. Yeah, you can hear me now.
Turn it up to 11.
Dragged on Monday morning, coffee strong, pouring everything you got into a paycheck Friday night. Your power stroke, diesel, backhoe riding king, 18-wheeler driving, living life in between the lines of clocking in and quitting time. But then the six-string circus comes to town, we hang them speakers over the crowd. When the lights come on, everybody's screaming, lighters in the sky, yeah, everybody's singing, every word to every song of the girl they're singing. Thinking the same thing.
We on the same page
cause
we sipping the same drink.
But here's a little something to thank y'all for showing up. Al Dean and the boys are about to blow it up. When the lights come on, everybody's screaming, lighters in the sky, yeah, everybody's singing, every word to every song of the girl they're taking tonight. When the lights come on, everybody's feeling a hallelujah. From the floor to the ceiling, yeah, the drink that we're there with, the smoke that we're there with, the party we're through, it's going all night long. When the lights come on, when the lights come on, your buzz boiling up, it's going all night long. When the lights come on.
Going down and the weekend's here. Save my soul. I can feel it coming, troubles in the air. Coming, troubles in the air.
About to give you the rock, now pour. Give me
Change of heart. back from the start like. Looked around, seen his wife on the military all over the whole compound. Soon as he seen it, I swear it, I mean it. My man was gone quicker than Bominos. He in jail. Everyone falling like dominoes. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that fist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that fist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, looking at, feeling that, flicking that wrist.
Logic. Clockwise, counterclockwise, realest in the top five. Other four ain't rapping. I'm just repping for the side. Yeah, that's coastlines, Panama for the boat.